So hello everyone, and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247, where we are going to discuss, guys, some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And guys, today's session is very important because, guys, we are going to discuss about the first advanced estimate of the national income. So do watch the complete session and spread the knowledge. But before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon if you are coming here for the first time. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily videos. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question, which talks about a very special ambulance which is known as Rakshita Ambulance. So DRDO Laboratory, which is Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Sciences, has launched this bike ambulance, motorcycle ambulance, which is known as Rakshita. And the question is, this has been handed over to which of the following paramilitary forces? कौन सी paramilitary force को ये bike ambulance, or you can say the motorcycle ambulance, has been handed over? So let's talk about this. So this is the ambulance, guys, of this type. So this panel where this person is lying, it will be attached to this motorcycle and then उसको लेके जाया जाएगा. Okay. So the Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Sciences, which is a Delhi-based DRDO laboratory, has handed over this motorcycle ambulance, which is named as Rakshita, to CRPF. CRPF, which stands for Central Reserve Police Force. So CRPF को handover किया गया है this Rakshita ambulance by the Delhi-based DRDO laboratory, which is known as Institute of Nuclear Medicine and Allied Sciences. So you should remember the name of this laboratory also, and it is located in Delhi. And of course, guys, DRDO chairperson is Mr. G. Satish Reddy. Right? I hope you all know this. G. Satish Reddy is the DRDO chairperson. And moving ahead, these are some, guys, the benefits and the usage of this bike ambulance. So it will, of course, provide life-saving aid for the evacuation of injured patients from those areas which are low-lying and from those areas which are hard to reach, from those streets which are congested. And it will also help in overcoming the problems that are being faced by the security forces and in the emergency conditions. Right? So basically, ये bike ambulance काफी ज़्यादा helpful होगा in the congested areas, in the hard to reach places, जहाँ पे proper जो car वाली ambulances है वो नहीं पहुँच सकती, वहाँ पे इन bike ambulance के through the patients can be evacuated. Right? So therefore, the correct answer is what? Option B, CRPF. Option B, CRPF is the correct answer, and CRPF, the constituting instrument is CRPF Act of 1949. It was constituted by CRPF Act of 1949, and currently Dr. A.P. Maheshwari is the Director General of CRPF. Okay, you should remember the Director General of all the paramilitary forces. And now let's move on to question number 2. This is also, guys, a very important question because it talks about a scheme. So with which ministry, KVIC, Khadi Village and Industries Commission, has signed an MOU for partnership to implement Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program. So there is a scheme which is known as Prime Minister Employment Generation Program, which is being implemented by the Ministry of MSME. And for this scheme, KVIC is the nodal implementing agency. And for the proper and for the more efficient implementation of this scheme, KVIC has signed an MOU with one more ministry. So you have to identify that ministry. Alright. So let's talk about this news. So this MOU, guys, has been signed between KVIC and the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, which is currently headed by Arjun Singh Munda. Okay. So Khadi and Village Industry Commission and Ministry of Tribal Affairs have signed two MOUs. Ye do MOU signed hue hain. Number one MOU is regarding the purchase of Khadi fabric for the Eklavya Model Residential Schools. Jo Eklavya Model Residential School hai, that are made specially for the ST students, for the tribal students, wahan pe Khadi fabric को खरीदने के लिए वहां पे जो दरी होती है बेसिकली द मैट्स, ओके, खादी फैब्रिक से बनी हुई मैट्स को खरीदने के लिए दिस एमओयू हैज बीन साइन द फर्स्ट एमओयू. एंड द सेकंड एमओयू, गाइस, इज फॉर यू नो द प्रॉपर इंप्लीमेंटेशन, द बेटर इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन प्रोग्राम. ओके, द सेकंड एमओयू इज ऑन पार्टनरिंग ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स मिनिस्ट्री विद केवीआईसी एज एन इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी फॉर द इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन प्रोग्राम. ऑलराइट. And moving ahead, if you talk more about the first MOU, so the Ministry of Tribal Affairs will procure over 6 lakh meters of khadi fabric worth around 15 crores in this financial year 2020-21 for the students in Eklavya Model Residential Schools, as I told you. And talking about the second MOU, so the National Scheduled Tribal Finance Development Corporation will act as an implementing agency will act as a, you know, help will act as a partner in implementing the Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program. Right. So the National Scheduled Tribal Finance Development Corporation will be roped in as a partner to implement this scheme, which is known as Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program. And this scheme, guys, was launched in the year 2008 by the Ministry of MSME, as I told you, and its implementing agency is KVIC. And talking more about this scheme, so the basic objective, guys, of this scheme is to generate the employment opportunities generate karna by establishing micro enterprises in the non-farm sector. All right, non-farm sector mein micro enterprises ko establish karne ke liye, and thereby creating the employment opportunities. This scheme was launched in the year 2008. Okay, and it was launched after merger of two schemes. Number one was Prime Minister's Rozgar Yojana. One scheme was Prime Minister Rozgar Yojana. Another was Rural Employment Generation Program. So there were two schemes which were merged to launch Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program in the year 2008. Ministries MSME and implementing agencies KVIC. Alright. So I hope you can easily answer this question, guys. So therefore, the correct answer is option C, Ministry of Travel Affairs, because here you have to identify that ministry with which KVIC has signed this MOU. Alright. And now let's move on to question number three. Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, which is Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan. Alright. Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan is the Minister for Petroleum and Natural Gas, has launched two welfare projects of a Maharatna in Betul districts of MP. So you have to name that Maharatna. So guys, there are 10 Maharatna in our country, and this Maharatna which we are talking about in this question is ONGC. ONGC is this Maharatna jiske do welfare projects ko launch kiya hai Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas ne in Betul districts of MP. And ONGC was established, guys, in the year 1956, and currently Shashi Shankar is the MD and CEO of ONGC. Right, and these are the two projects. Kaun se do projects hai uski bhi baat kar leni chahiye. So number one, there is a hostel cum training facility at Bharat Bharati Shiksha Samiti. That's this hostel cum training facility has been opened to train poor farmers in the field of organic farming. ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग के फील्ड में पुअर फार्मर्स को ट्रेन करने के लिए दिस होस्टल कम ट्रेनिंग फैसिलिटी हैज बीन बिल्ट एट द कैंपस ऑफ भारत भारती शिक्षा समिति. और इसका जो ओवरऑल कॉस्ट है वो कितना है, ₹3 करोड़ का, एंड अप्रोक्सीमेटली 15,000 to 20,000 फार्मर्स विल गेट बेनिफिट थ्रू दिस फैसिलिटी. राइट, एंड अनदर प्रोजेक्ट इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सोलर चूलास टू द पुअर हाउस होल्ड्स इन द बेतुल डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ एमपी. एंड दीज सोलर चूलास आर बींग बिल्ट बाय IIT बॉम्बे with a total investment of how much? ₹90 lakh. Okay, 90 lakh ke total investment pe IIT Bombay ne ye solar chula banaye hai, and these solar chulas has been distributed to the poor households in Betul district by ONGC, and this project was launched by Dharmendra Pradhan, who is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Alright, so therefore, guys, here the correct answer is what, option D, ONGC. Alright, and now let's move on to question number 4 and 5. So question number 4 and 5 are based on the advanced estimates of national income. So let's talk about it first, and then we will move on to question number 4 and question number 5. So National Statistical Office, which is headed by the chief statistician of our country, who is Mr. K. Shivaji. Chhatrapati Shivaji is the, that is not that Chhatrapati Shivaji, his name is also Chhatrapati Shivaji. So National Statistical Office, which is headed by the chief statistician of India, which is K. Shivaji, and it works under the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, has released the first advanced estimates of national income 2020-2021, and this is based on the benchmark indicator method. Okay, kiske upar based hai ye benchmark indicator method ke upar based hai, and what is this method? So guys, in this method basically there are various indicators with the help of which the data have been collected. बहुत सारे indicators होते हैं और उन indicators के base पे जो data है वो collect किया जाता है, and this is known as the benchmark indicator method. And now let's move on to the data. So अगर हम GDP की बात करते हैं, so the overall current value of GDP as per this estimate is 134.40 lakh crore, with a growth of -7.7%, and the growth इन एवरी कॉम्पोनेंट इज नेगेटिव. हर कॉम्पोनेंट में जो ग्रोथ है, ग्रोथ परसेंटेज है, वो नेगेटिव ही रही है, एज वी ऑल नो, बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड 19. Gross value added, it is 1,23.40 lakh crore minus 7.2%. Net domestic product 118.90 lakh crore with a growth of minus 7.8%. Gross national income 132.70 lakh crore with a growth percentage of minus 7.9%. Net national income, it is 117.20 lakh crore with a growth of minus 8%. Per capita GDP, it's rupees 99,155 with a growth of minus 8.7%. Then we have per capita gross national income, which is rupees 97,899 with a growth percentage of minus 8.9%. While finally, per capita net national income is how much? Rupees 86,456 with a growth percentage of minus 8.9%. Now, itna sara data kaise yaad rakhenge? The question is this. So you have to remember the value of GDP. Okay, this is important. You have to remember the growth percentage of GDP. Of course, this is important, and you have to remember this net national income, per capita GDP, and per capita NNI. So these are the most important. Otherwise, agar aapko sara yaad ho jata hai, then that is well and good. Okay, and these are guys at the constant prices, and the base year was 2011-12 for the constant prices. Now talking about the current prices. So at the current prices, GDP is how much? The value 194.80 lakh crore with a growth of minus 4.2%. All right, then we have gross value added, which is 175.76 lakh crore with a growth of minus 4.2%. Net domestic product, it is 174.50 lakh crore with a negative growth of 4.2%. Gross national income, it is 192.40 lakh crore minus 4.4% is the growth rate. Then we have net national income at 172.09 lakh crore with a growth rate of with a negative growth rate of 4.4. Then we have per capita GDP rupees 1,43,734 minus 5.2% is the growth rate. While per capita GNI, it is 1,41,945 minus 5.4% is the growth rate. While per capita net national income is 1,26,968 with a negative growth rate of 5.4%. All right. So this was estimate at the current prices, and this was at the constant prices. I hope all these things are clear. And now let's come back to question number 4 and 5. So question number 4, guys, is very easy. I hope you can easily answer it now. Which of the following methods has been used in calculating the advanced estimates of national income? So the method that has been used, guys, is what? Benchmark indicator method, in which various indicators are used to collect the data. Okay, and question number 5 is what? So you have to consider these statements 1, 2, 3 regarding the advanced estimates of national income, and you have to identify the correct statement identify karna hai. So GDP growth at constant prices is estimated at minus 7.7%. This is absolutely correct, and the value is 134.40 lakh crore, okay, at the constant prices. And per capita NNI at constant prices rupees 86,456. So as I told you, you have to remember about the NNI. So this statement, guys, is also correct. And per capita GDP growth at current prices is estimated as minus 5.2%, which is again absolutely correct, which means all the statements are correct here. Therefore, option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer. Okay, I hope, guys, this question is clear, and that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.